One of the results of these budget and debt ceiling negotiations, beyond averting the default, seems to have been that there's a bit more goodwill that's been built up between the President and Speaker McCarthy and their teams. So I'm wondering, do you guys see any opportunities for bipartisan legislation going forward, and what is next on this administration's legislative agenda?
Look, we've seen under this president, there's been about 350 pieces of bipartisan legislation that this president has signed into law. Many of those were historic pieces of legislation. When you think about the bipartisan infrastructure legislation, Inflation Reduction Act, all these pieces of legislation that's going to create good-paying jobs, lower costs for healthcare costs for Americans, lower energy costs for Americans, CHIPS and Science Act, when you think about manufacturing jobs, creating manufacturing jobs in this country. So look, these are all important things, important issues that the president wants to continue to work on, to continue to implement. And I talked about the gun reform. We believe that there is a common sense approach here that we can move forward and work with Congress on. Reproductive rights, we believe that this is something that we need to continue to work very hard towards, making sure that the wealthy pay their fair share as well, and not just leave it on the little guy. And so look, we're going to continue to work on an economy that works for everyone, making sure that it we build it from the bottom up, middle out. Those are the things that the president feels that he needs to continue to work towards. And so, yeah, there are places that we see that could be a bipartisanship here. If we're really serious about the deficit, really serious about making sure that we reduce the deficit, the president put forth a budget plan March 9th on how we can reduce the deficit by $3 trillion in the next 10 years. And so, yeah, there are ways that we believe that we can move forward here with Congress.
Any plans for the President and the Speaker to meet again in a non-crisis, non-emergency setting?
No plans yet.
And then secondly,
dear friends, this is it. There are a total of 4 big changes that may affect your wallet this year. President Biden has laid out several proposals that would completely change Social Security. The cost of living adjustment may also be increased by a significant amount once this plan is approved. My dear friends, please make sure that you watch until the end of this video to hear about all of the new details. Also, this coming Friday, I will be announcing more winners for the Walmart gift card giveaway. If you'd like to enter the weekly giveaway, friends, all you need to do is click and like several of my videos and then comment below the keyword of each video that you watch. The more videos that you watch and then comment on, the greater your chances, my friends, of winning the giveaways. As a Social Security, Old Age, and Survivors Insurance Trust Fund faces depletion by 2033, President Biden has suggested what many experts call a sweeping 4-point plan to bolster funds in the trust and help fill the $22.4 trillion funding shortfall that is shown in the 2023 trustees report. If the federal government cannot fix this shortage, it could result in benefit cuts of up to 24% for millions of retirees beginning in 2033. While some of Biden's proposed changes will affect mostly high earners and company executives, some of the changes will affect middle and lower income wage earners, especially those who may rely on Social Security benefits in the near future. The first proposed change is to implement payroll tax for income over $400,000. Currently, any earned income below $160,200 is subject to a 12.4% payroll tax. Earnings exceeding that amount are not subject to OASI taxes. Biden plans to tax earned income above $400,000, leaving wages above $160,200 up to $400,000 untaxed. The second proposed change is to change the way that COLA increases are calculated. Each year, Social Security benefits are assessed based on inflation and adjusted through COLA. Currently, the administration uses the CPIW to calculate COLA, but this number does not necessarily reflect the lifestyle and expenses of retired individuals. Shifting COLA calculations to figures tied to the consumer price index for the elderly will not solve the problem of Social Security running out of money. But it could put more money into the pockets of retired Americans who need it the most. The third proposed change is to increase a primary insurance amount. The primary insurance amount is a figure indicating how much money you will receive in Social Security benefits, depending on the age you begin claiming benefits and your average index monthly earnings. Increasing the primary insurance amount for Americans aged 78 to 82 years old will help those who experience rising expenses, such as health care, later in life. The fourth proposed change is to increase a special minimum benefit for lifetime lower-wage workers. Currently, low-wage earners receive a special minimum benefit, regardless of how much they made while they worked. In 2023, a lifetime low-earning worker would receive just $12,402 in Social Security benefits per year, or $1,033 per month. President Biden plans to increase the minimum benefit to 125% of the federal poverty level. As an example, in 2023, someone receiving the special minimum benefit would have received $1,518 per month with the boost. Last year, fallout from the crisis drove inflation to a four-decade high, and the rising costs of rent, grocery, and monthly utilities put many Americans in a difficult financial position. So now, more than half of Americans dipped into their savings accounts just to cover everyday expenses, and some families even reported skipping meals to make ends meet. Not surprisingly, financial headwinds left some retired workers in an unpleasant spot. Trillions of dollars disappeared from retirement accounts as the stock market plummeted, and the buying power of Social Security benefits declined as prices increased across the economy. The only silver lining was the historic cost of living adjustment applied to Social Security payments this year to offset inflation. Social Security benefits received an 8.7% COLA in 2023, which was the biggest raise for retired workers since 1982 and the fourth largest raise in history. Inflation causes money to lose purchasing power over time. So in other words, $20 will buy you fewer goods and services today than it did just a few years ago, and far fewer goods and services than it did a few decades ago. So annual COLAs are intended to preserve the buying power of Social Security payments by keeping benefits aligned with inflation. The Senior Citizens League policy analyst, Mary Johnson, says that retired workers will receive a 3.1% COLA in 2024. Many may be disappointed by that information. Well, my awesome and amazing friends, that is the end of my daily stimulus update video for this Monday. My dearest friends, thank you very, very much for being here and for being part of this community. To say thank you and to show my appreciation, I will be announcing several winners for the Walmart gift card giveaway this coming Friday. If you'd like to enter the weekly giveaway, friends, all you have to do is click and like several of my videos and then comment below the keyword of each video that you watch. The more videos that you watch and then comment on, the greater your chances, dear friends, of winning the giveaways. Thank you and have a wonderful and very blessed week.